Hello, hello, everyone. It is Wonderful Wednesday, our Children's Bible Study. I'm Yolanda with the Bates Memorial Children's Church 3Me Ministry. So glad you're here with us, children. I hope you've been out and about and having fun and just enjoying life. Children, parents, I hope everything's going well with you and your family. I do say thank you for allowing the children to be connected with us here at the Bates Memorial 3Me Ministry. All righty, so it's a wonderful day in the neighborhood. We got our Bible study going on. It's still the New Year's. I say Happy New Year's to you guys. And I just pray that so much newness is coming upon you. And we know here that we are having our word of the week, which is self-control. And I'm so excited about how God's going to use me to be self-controlled. And you know what? He's already done. I had an incident and I responded and I was controlled. I was like, yes, I had self-control when I did it. And I felt so good. And I know that it was the word of God, children. It was the word of God that was in me that rised up and would allow me to be in control and control myself. So I'm hoping everything's going well with you guys. Stay in that word because God has so much he wants to share with you, show you, tell you, and expose to you, okay? All righty. So we're going to go ahead and we'll start out. I have your word for the week, and we're going to dig in a little deeper with the lesson we had on Sunday. So before, we want to make sure we have our Bible, our bodies positioned in the camera, our brain ready to receive the word of God, yes, and that we have no outside distraction of any kind, giving God 100% of this 10, 15, 20 minutes that we have here, okay? All right, so let us go ahead. Let us go to God in prayer. Let us bow our heads and close our eyes. Father God, we thank you for this Wednesday. We thank you, Lord, for last night laying down and this morning early rising. We pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that You led us and guide us, oh Father God, in all the wonderful ways, oh Father God, your covering and protection. We thank you, oh Lord. We thank you that our family is all well, Father God. And for those that may be experiencing a death in the family, Father God, we pray for comfort, oh Father God. Comfort them in a special way, oh Father God. Wrap your loving arms around them, Father God, and let them know that you will be with them throughout the whole duration of the process of them losing their loved one. Father God, I pray, oh Father God, for those that don't know you as Lord and Savior, I pray, Father God, that they will accept you, oh Father God. Father God, knowing that you died on the cross for their sin, but you did not stay dead. On the third day, you rose with all power, and that power is existing in us, oh Father God. We say thank you, Lord. We want to live this beautiful, abundant life for you, but we know it's through your word, oh Father God, and through our obedience, oh Father God. And Lord, we just want to do that. So I pray for every viewer and those that are connected, being connected with us, oh Father God, that we continue to read your word, that we continue to, that you would grant us the wisdom and understanding, Father God, of your word, oh Father God. And Lord, we just pray for self-control and that we be a better person than we was yesterday. Now have your way. Open our hearts. We open our hearts to be able to receive what you have for us today. Amen and amen. All right, I will be giving you the question of the week answer on the end at towards the end of our time. So broken down walls, and we talked about the broken down walls. We talked about King Solomon being the wisest king, and that he built a city. He built a big old wall around the whole city, and it was like the defense. It was important. It was the defense to protect the city from attacks and the enemy, and keep the people safe and let them live in harmony. And so we looked at that and said that when we have a broken down wall, meaning we are not being obedient, okay? We're not being disciplined in God. But when we have the wall is a sign of being disciplined, okay? Discipline. And we said here, discipline is what? Being self-control, okay? Discipline, let's say discipline is being self-control, okay? So, and we know that that's what God wants us to do. And so we talked about that discipline makes us what? Strong. It makes us strong. It makes us strong to be able to deal with the things that comes our way, unexpected circumstances, and it will help us to be able to be in control when those things happen. It pops up out of nowhere, okay? That word, it will help and make us strong to know that God got it. You know, victory is ours. He give us every tool we need. And just like the scripture for this week is, it says God has given us power for everything we need, okay? So no matter what comes our way, guess what? We got it. We got it, and God got our back, okay? So that's the confidence that God wants us to have in his word and when those things come, okay? So discipline and self-control, okay? So remain in control to keep yourself out of danger. And when you are not disciplined, you are out of control. And when you're out of control, you are headed towards danger, okay? I did not share with you guys the focus of the week. And the focus of the week, I didn't share with you on Sunday, but when you lose control, it can cause trouble, okay? So we want to always try our best to stay in self-control because it keeps us in control to do all the things that God has for us. And always remember at the end of the tunnel and at the end of that thing you're going through, it's always a blessing. Yes, it is, all righty? Because God is always trying to teach us something in any and everything we go through. He's trying to get our attention so that we can get it as we're going through it. And when we get at the end, we get the blessings. Yes, and we become what? Stronger. So children, do you want to be strong? Guess what? You get the word of God in you. Amen. So we must rely on God. We must say that we must rely on God. A lot of times, guess what we do? We want to rely on everybody else but God. Okay. We want to call on everybody else but God. But God said, no, you need to consult me. And he ain't telling us not to talk to individuals, not to trust an individual. But he said, don't leave me out because I am the one that is in total control. Okay. So we must rely on God for help and for him to help us to be able to choose self-control. So the next time when you in something, make sure you choose self-control. And it's only two things you can choose, right? You either can choose to be self-control are out of control, okay? And we don't want to be out of control. Children, I'm going to let you know, I know you get an attitude sometimes when things don't go your way, and sometimes you may get upset, but let me tell you something. Learn how to stop, pause, and maybe be silent, maybe give yourself a little time so that you can choose the right one. And I pray that with the God in you, that you would choose to be self-control, okay? So remember, if you're ever in a tough situation, and I'm talking to everybody that's listening right now, if you ever in a tough situation, remember you can talk to God. You can talk to God about it, and he wants to hear about it. He doesn't matter how small it is, and he doesn't matter how big it is. God said, bring all your worries, everything that concerns you, bring it to me, because I want to be a part of it, okay? And I want to bless you, and I want you to know that I got this. I'm with you. You're not by yourself, okay? So remember that you can always go to God and talk to God about that, and that's in prayer. Amen? So when we do that, we ask God to give us strength, okay? Ask God to give us strength so that we can make the wise choice. Read the Bible so that we can remember and be reminded that God loves us, okay? Because sometimes we feel that we're all alone. Sometimes we may feel that people don't love us. But always remember that God loves you, okay? Talk to people that God has put in your life that can help you to think things through so that you can stay in control, okay? So God is so good, and we want to make sure we be disciplined. Discipline and self-control. And when we do these things, it makes God proud of us. It makes God happy and rejoice, okay? And it does great things in our lives and what's to come, because it's going to make us stronger, and it leads us down the path where God wants us to be. And that's where blessings and joy and peace and all those things that you dreamed of and some of those things you never could imagine, it's down that road, okay? And so, but we only can receive that if we are disciplined and we are in control. And when we do that, guess what? We are living for the Lord Jesus Christ, who is our Savior. All righty? So no broken down walls. We want to keep those walls up so we can be disciplined and in control, be safe, and God cover us and take care of us and let us live the abundant life. So for our question for the week, let's go to that. And the question of the week was our scripture text, which is Proverbs chapter 25, verse 28. The question says, what is a person like without self-control? Now, before I do this, let me tell you something. I choose not to be around individuals that are out of control. Because as I said earlier, when you're out of control, you better believe it, trouble and danger is coming its way. And I don't want to be around that, okay? So if that's you, take in mind, it's not too many people want to be around somebody that's out of control. So maybe make sure you know and say, hey, I want to make sure I control myself because I like people around me, okay? And I like people around me that loves the Lord and that's going to, that I can benefit and they can benefit from me, okay? So what is a person like out without self-control, okay? Let's go to the scripture. Everything is from in the scripture. Proverbs chapter 25 and verse 28. And the Bible reads, that person is like a city broken into. So the city is broken into and left without walls. So is a person who lacks self-control. So it's just like that picture, that image I showed you on Sunday. Remember I showed you that on Sunday? Where the walls been broke through and the enemies comes up. And guess what? We know that there's danger. You know, there's things that's going to happen that God don't intend to happen, okay? So don't put us in a situation, don't put yourself in a situation where you allow something to happen in your life and God said it didn't have to be that way if we would have had self-control, if we would have called upon God, if we would have chose to be silent for a while, give yourself some time, think it over, talk to somebody, go to God in prayer, read the Bible, and remember that God loves you, okay? So we have to do those things so that we will not run into things that we don't have to run into just because of we being out of control. Okay. All righty. So that was our question of the week. That was our lesson for the Wednesday. And I hope that you all read your whole Proverbs chapter 25. That was your challenge reading. If not, you still got time because we got Thursday, Friday, Saturday. You got 3 more days. And don't get me wrong, the chapters are not that long. A lot of chapters are long. It's pretty much in the Old Testament. Yes, they can go to 30, sometimes 40 chapters, okay? They can go fairly long with a lot of verses. But if you read the word each day, you have nothing to worry about. And that's what I want. I want you to get in a habit of reading God's word each and every day, okay? I hope you had time to be able to tune into our Black Story Time that was on Monday and having your family gather and you all discuss. So I'm hoping to see you guys on Sunday for another lesson and make sure that you all stay in control. And when I get finished praying, we're going to go ahead and we're going to read our verse for the month. And I'm hoping that you all are reading it and you know that by heart already, okay? Let us go to God in prayer. Father God, we love you. We thank you for this lesson. Lord, let us know that when unexpected circumstances come, Father God, we know that we can choose to be in control. We know that out of control, it brings danger, it causes problem and trouble. And not only that, but it affects other people who we love, oh Father God. So help us, oh Lord, to be more humble and more patient and slow to speak and slow to be angry, Father God. Please, oh Lord, we know that with that word in us, it will help us and it will give us the power. It will make us stronger and it will give us the strength to stand up and to stand up strong in a loving way so that we will get the victory. Lord, I thank you and I love you for this time and all the visitors that are here with us on this Wednesday Bible study, Father God, and I pray that their life-changing experience is going to happen this year, newness and abundance, oh Father God, and Lord, just let them know, if anything, that you love them no matter what. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All righty. So verse for the whole month is coming from 2 Peter chapter 1, and it's verse 3. And it says, God has given us power for everything we need. Hold on, I think I messed up. But God's power has given, I did it right. God's power has given us everything we need to live a godly life. Let me say that again. God's power has given us everything we need to live or lead a godly life. Okay? So we want to be able to do it. And I can ram this up and say, with that piece right there, we get God's power and become strong by being disciplined when I tack that scripture to this lesson. Now, when I tack that scripture to the lesson last week about Jesus being tempted in the wilderness while he was fasting, okay, I can tempt that is that Jesus was able to defeat the devil 3 times because he used the power of God and it didn't let him bow down. I didn't let him do things that was outside of God's will, and it was God's power that led him through that. All right? So you see how that scripture will help? So you will be able to know it, and when you know it, you will know how to connect it with other things, okay? And then try to connect it with some things in your life as well, okay? All righty. So I'm out of here. Hope you all had a wonderful time here today, because I did. And you all continue to stay blessed, stay safe, stay safe, stay safe, and just continue to do what God's calling you to do. And I will see you on Sunday. Take care and bye-bye.